scripture this morning comes from the book of Thessalonians, 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, the 16th through the 18th verse. And I believe it will appear for those who are in our listening audience, coming to us via YouTube. And it reads thusly: Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. What a powerful, powerful scripture. Now, for a little history, this scripture is included in the first of two letters that Paul wrote to the church he founded in Thessalonica. And it was made up mostly of young Gentiles. We know the Gentiles were non-Jews, and it had women in it as well. And every one past of these young converts was fully committed to Christ. And they looked forward to his second coming. Paul had challenged them to continually live holy lives, despite any suffering or persecutions, to stay ready for Christ's return. They were to live their lives day to day in such a way that pleased God and that was worthy of them being called a Christian. Can you imagine? Live in such a way that was worthy of them being called a Christian, a follower of Christ. He also wanted them to make sure that in doing all of this, that they had and maintained their own personal relationship with God, their own personal relationship with Christ. Amen? Praise God. And this is just part of what Paul provided to them in terms of a teaching, but we can take these same scriptures and look at them as a today message, Pastor. A today message, amen? Because we as children of God also need to live as though Christ is coming again, amen? As though, and be ready in case he comes today, because the word says we know not the day or the hour when he will come, amen? Praise God. So we have to keep our house in order. Praise God, hallelujah. And this scripture can also be used not just in terms of the holy lives that we live, but also in terms of our prayer life, because our prayer life is a direct relation to the life and the love and the relationship that we have with Christ. Amen? Praise God. It is our lifeline to Christ. Amen? Praise God. So, then, as children of God, have to live our lives worthy of Christ. Worthy of Christ and being called a Christian. Amen? Praise God. Staying ready daily for his return. Having our own, also our own personal relationship with Christ. Amen? Praise God. I know my mama was a Bible praying lady and she prayed for me, but she can't get me into heaven. I got to have my own personal relationship to make it into heaven. Amen? Praise God. So I want us to look briefly at three points in this scripture, concentrating on the second one regarding prayer. Those three points are rejoicing always, praise God, unceasing prayer, and giving thanks. Rejoicing always. We are to always rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord always. Amen? Praise God. The scripture in Nehemiah 8:10 and C says, the joy of the Lord is your strength. I want to personalize that. I say the joy of the Lord is my strength. Amen? Praise God. And joy is better than happiness. Because happiness is temporary and based on the circumstances, amen? You might wake up this morning and you don't feel too good. You don't feel like saying nothing to the Lord, amen? Praise God. But if you Google joy, joy is having joy inside. It's an loving kindness and his grace, which is unmerited favor. You didn't do anything for it, but out of love, God gave it to you. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And when you have joy from the Lord, you can go through hardship. You can go through pain. You can go through grief. The world don't understand why you can stand there and take it, but you can take it because you're strengthened by the Lord. Through the joy that I have, amen, it gives me strength. I can remember a time in my life when I didn't have joy. And you know, there are a lot of folks out there don't even realize, Pastor, because I didn't know I didn't have joy. Praise God. They don't know they don't have joy. They don't know that there's something out there else that they can have if they had Jesus. Amen. Praise God. I had happiness. I was happy sometimes, and sometimes I was sad, and sometimes I was a little depressed. Amen. Praise God. I went to church and went on a Sunday. As soon as I left church, I tossed my Bible in the back seat. Didn't take it up again until I went back to church the next Sunday. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes people don't realize that they're playing church, doing all the right stuff. Amen. All the things you're taught to do. Amen. But you don't have the relationship that you need to have in your heart with Christ. Amen. Praise God. But I got to tell you, that changed. It changed when my daddy died. I was literally crushed. My heart was broken into a million pieces. I didn't know how I was going to go on. And the Sunday that I went to church after his homegoing service, they had to carry me out of the church. I was so broken. I had religion, you see, but I didn't have a relationship with Christ. Amen? Praise God. I had religion like Job did, everything right. You know, he prayed for his kids just in case they didn't do something right. Amen? He did all of the things he read about and heard about. Praise God. But they say that Job knew what to say. He knew about him, but he didn't know about it within himself. Amen? Praise God. I knew, I'd studied all of this stuff about God. You know, I knew all of this stuff. I could say all of the stuff that everybody else said, but I didn't have him. That deep personal relationship in my heart, amen? I had religion, but I didn't have the deep, close relationship with Jesus Christ. Not until this unthinkable death happened and I looked to Jesus for comfort and solace. I look to Jesus to fill the void in my life. I look to Jesus because he was the only one. He was the only one who could give me strength. Praise God. Hallelujah. This joy, the Lord gave me strength. Praise God. Hallelujah. The joy I have, like I said, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. We got to be joyously rejoicing always in the Lord because he gives us joy and it's permanent, not temporary. Amen? Praise God. Let me move on to unceasing prayer. Prayer and praying is about more than the position you're in when you pray. Praise God. You can pray standing up. You can pray kneeling down. Praise God. It's about what's in your heart, amen, and your mindset. That is your attitude. Your attitude, amen. You can't go before the Lord our God half-stepping when you pray. We have to be all in, trusting and believing that God will answer our prayers, amen. Praise God. Never doubt it, for as Pastor said, doubting is unbelief. Prayer is defined as a solemn request for help or an expression of thanks addressed to God. It's having an honest, heartfelt conversation with God while calling on the name of Jesus, for you can't get to the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Let me just break that down. It says the effective, intensely passionate prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And ladies, that doesn't leave you out, because when God talks, when the Bible says man, it means mankind. It's talking about you too. Amen? Praise God. So God promises us in his word that we have only to ask and we shall receive it. Now somebody might say, well, how do you know that? I know it because the Bible tells me so. Amen. Praise God. And what's in the Bible is truth, because God's word is truth. Isaiah 65:24 says, before they call, I will answer, and while they're still speaking, I will hear. 1 John 5:14 says, this is the confidence which we have before him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And what is his will? God's will is his word. Amen? Praise God. Hallelujah. John 14:14 says, if you ask me anything in my name, I will do it. And let's just listen to Ephesians 6:18, which says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Children of God, we should always pray. We should always pray, because prayer is the most powerful tool we have as Christians. Amen? John Wesley said that God does nothing but an answer to prayer. Praise God. Dr. Miles Monroe says that prayer is exercising the authority of dominion on earth that God gave to mankind. He gave us the power. Amen? Through man, God is able to accomplish his will and purpose on earth. Now that's powerful. That is power. Amen? We have been given power by God to change things on earth. Change things in your life. Change things in the world. Amen? Praise God. Again, our prayer life is the lifeline to Christ. Now, when I went through the grief of my dad's death, which lasted for months, I found myself prostrated, Pastor, and I was wailing many a day and night. I was wailing and crying unto the Lord. I prayed that God would change my heart of stone to a heart of flesh so that I could better receive his word. I read over 100 Christian books as directed by the Holy Spirit. So you can't read anything. You got to read that which the Holy Spirit says is in line with God's will and his word. Amen. Praise God. I read the Bible at least twice, front to cover, cover to cover. Amen. Praise God. And I asked God to purge me, Pastor, of anything in me that was not like him. My constant prayer from the beginning was me calling on the name of Jesus. Sometimes the only thing you can say is Jesus. Jesus, 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 amen? Because Jesus is the word incarnate, amen? Jesus, 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 praise God, hallelujah. And then I was so blessed when God blessed me on Christmas Eve of that year with a gift of spiritual baptism. The Comforter came in strong and with much power through my prayers, amen? Let me just tell you, God answers prayers. Oh, God, God answers prayers. It says, do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is my strength. For his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Amen. Psalm 35. So go to God in prayer. Know that the more you pray, the more your relationship with God will grow. Amen. More prayer.
need to do something before I close. Need to do something. Good God Almighty. Didn't she preach this morning? Woo! She has reinforced in my spirit why she's going to be over our prayer and intercession ministers. She's got a plan laid out. You're going to get an email shortly if you want to be a part of our prayer and intercession ministry. We're reorganizing all of that. This just confirms. Oh, she preached this morning. She preached this morning. Come on, give God some praise. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. Give God some praise.